After finishing my Mandalorian build, I knew what my next project had to be. A 3D printed life-size Grogu. I searched online and found a set of free STL files to do just that. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. This is a model I was really excited to get started on. I was able to find free files for a fully articulated life-size Grogu. This was a big project, so in this video I'm going to go over the printing and assembly. In the next video I'll go over the painting and clothing. Alright, let's get started. There are 55 files to print, with some of them needing to be doubled. So overall, there are 78 parts to print. I went with a matte green PLA so I can leave them as raw prints. Most of the parts will be hidden under his clothing anyway, so there's no need to finish them. This ends up saving a lot of time and was better with all the movable joints. I put an affiliate link in the description for the material that I used. The full build is almost 1 kilogram, not including the supports, so I recommend getting 2 rolls like I did. After everything is printed, I remove all of the supports. Besides most of the joint pieces, everything needed supports. Here are all the parts ready for assembly. As I mentioned, most parts will be hidden by Grogu's clothing, so I will assemble everything except for the head, ears, hands, and feet. I'll put those aside to be finished and painted later. Originally, I was going to leave the head as it was and just paint the eyes, then use resin over it to make it glossy. As I thought more about it, I decided to cut out the eyes from the print and make separate resin eyes. Here's how it'll look with the resin eyes. I'm really happy with the result, but I'll go over that more in detail in the next video. For right now, let's start the assembly of the parts. I start with the neck barbell and the body barbell. There's a part 1 and 2 for each. I glue each set together with the super glue gel. Next are the hinges for the joints. There are the upper leg hinges, elbow hinges, the foot hinges, shoulder hinges, and hand hinges. And now the ball joints to go with the hinges. There's the shoulders, elbows, and the upper legs. I would call them the hips, but I'm trying to keep the names of the parts in line with the names of the files that I downloaded. And again, there's a part 1 and 2, and you'll need to print doubles for each of these. I glue these and then use some rubber bands to hold them together as the glue cures. After the glue cures, I put the joints together. The pins are a tight fit, but I was able to assemble them without any sanding. Time to start putting the legs together. First, I want to show you that there's a slight difference on each side of these joints. If you put it in backwards, this connection will not fit in the body. Also, if you put the joint in the upper leg backwards, you'll notice that it's a little loose. So be sure to check both sides again before you glue the legs together. I add some dot to glue and then attach the other half. Then I do the same for the other leg, and again double checking that it's in the right way. Now I add the foot hinge to the lower leg and glue both halves together. Then the same for the other leg. Next step is to attach the legs to the lower body. Place the legs into the lower back of the body. Add dot to glue, then put the body barbell in place before gluing the front and back together. Put the lower leg in place and insert the knee pin. I did have to do some sanding on the knee pins because it was a very tight fit. After sanding the pins, it was still tight, but I was able to get them in. If the joints are too loose, then Grogu won't stay in place when you change how he's posed. Alright, let's get these arms put together. I put the shoulder and elbow hinges in place. The shoulder hinges are slightly different on each end, so make sure to check the fit before gluing in place. Then the same for the other arm. Put the hand hinge in place and glue together the lower arm. And again for the other arm. Now it's time to add the upper body. Start with the front because of the placement of the barbell. I push it in at a 90 degree angle. You will need to use a bit of force to get it to snap in. Then place the arms and the neck barbell and glue both halves together. Don't mind the arm falling off, or that one. Now I add the dots of glue. The last step for now is attaching the back. I still need to finish and paint the head, hands, and feet, so I won't assemble anything else for now. So here's the almost finished assembly. Now I need to get started on the eyes and the painting for the next video. The files used in this video were done by the Kit Cave. You can download them on things.com. I put the link in the description. I hope you enjoyed this video, the first part of my Grogu build. Be sure to like and subscribe, and check this out next. Thank you for watching.